Rise and shine. Rise and shine. Yes, it's me again. And I hope this time you'll cooperate without me needing to repeatedly hit you in the face, eh? Look, we just have to get this over and done with. Unless you want a visit from someone upstairs. And trust me, you don't. Just like before, no food until we're done here. And the moment you start getting on my nerves, we're going back to my tried and tested fists. So, tell me, what were you doing in the forest when the Red Shields caught you? Army, huh? If I were in charge, I wouldn't even consider letting you join. And you were... Ah. My father was a foot soldier, you know. One day, he got trampled by the cavalry. And that was the end of his glorious military career. Okay. That was easier than I expected. Now, unfortunately, we'll have to start...
I always found it puzzling that these people won't bathe. You, I understand, you're literally rotting in this damned cell, but them, there's just no excuse for the stench. There they are, finally. I know, you have a million questions forming in your head, but they'll have
And my faith will not falter.
Thank you.
you took your sweet time, eh? But I understand. I did too when I was leaving this place for the first time. You have to admit, the Red Priests are quite resourceful when it comes to death and dying. Great question, truly. But noticed, we're still within the walls of the Island Asylum. When we're out, then we'll talk. I'm told this path leads to the beach. I don't know how, but if it's true, then I'll wait there for you until dusk. Good luck.
waiting a long time for someone to find me. Are you here to help me leave this place? I do not know. I think it is some kind of prison deep in the weirdness. I might be. I do not know. Was I sent here for a reason? Did I end up here by accident, like you? Why are you here? Are men here that would explain the weirdness surrounding us? I've been here for what seems like an eternity. I feel I am getting restless. I wish I could answer. I cannot remember. I know I am not complete. I remember I once knew who I was at some point, but I do not anymore. I just am. You are looking for a way out yourself. I think we might be able to help one another with that. I shall do something now. But trust me, the discomfort will be worth the outcome. I am sorry I did not ask for your permission to do that, but I hope it was worth it, as promised. I found a bit of emptiness within your heart, a place where I could dwell for a while. I have already told you, I need your help to leave this place, and when we are out of here, I will need your help finding the rest of me to make me whole again. I feel I am but a shadow of what I once was. I will try to help as much as I can, but I need you to hold up your end of the bargain. Thank you. We shall meet again then. Find the weirdness and look for me within the darkness.
There he is. Now that we're all here, meet your new comrades, Conquer and Syria. Get some rest, people, and prepare for the journey. We're leaving at dusk.
Not so fast, brother. I'm not getting near a goddamn boat unless I know where I'm going.
Away from here, brother. Isn't that enough?
If you wish. But since we're all here and we have some time to kill, it would be nice if you finally explained what the hell's going on. You've helped us leave our cages, great. But even though we're grateful, you owe us an explanation. What do you want from us?
To show some damn gratitude, for one thing.
Caradoc, we weren't born yesterday. No one would risk getting into trouble with the priests for nothing. Why did you save us?
I need you to kill King Arthur.
You're insane. He's insane.
The King Arthur. There has already been dead for 600 years, King Arthur.
Precisely.
But he's dead.
You probably wouldn't have heard about it among the tribes, little picked. But every single time things go down the shitter on this island, a bunch of cowards in Camelot bring our once and future king back from the dead. It's happened before. It will happen again. And soon.
What a load of... Ah, fine. Have it your way. Let's say I believe you.
You can't be serious.
He believes that. There's no point in arguing with a madman. But that still doesn't explain why you saved us, Caradoc.
I wish I knew why I was ordered to save you three specifically. Personally, I don't see the appeal. But I don't question my orders, and if you get on my boat, you won't question mine. Understood? Now get some rest. The tide's not right just yet, but it will break and start working in our favor by dusk.
Fine. But where are we going, exactly?
To the Horns of the South.
Nice. A bunch of glorified fishermen who hate my people. Why would we stop there?
Do they teach you, Del Reader, anything? To take the Excalibur, obviously.
Obviously.
He's truly insane.
You'll see for yourself soon enough. Now pin these emblems to your clothes. They will grant you free passage to the Horns. And get some sleep. You all look like you're about to keel over, and we have a long journey ahead of us.
You have decided to trust Caradoc, at least for now. You have embarked on your journey towards the Horns of the South. But as soon as you found yourselves at sea, black clouds gathered over your heads, like tangible proof that there must be some curse on you. Soon the wind was howling, and the gargantuan waves were towering over you. You found yourselves in the heart of a storm. The only thing you remember is the deafening roar of cracking wood and then darkness. You open your eyes. You are alive.